Hello and welcome to this lecture. So in this lecture we'll see how to just make that payload run in the client computer and get complete connection to the Kali machine, and we'll just execute some of the commands. So before doing that, let me just open the Firefox and let's see how powerful our payload is to bypass all of that antiviruses. So let's open this. Let me just close this Veil framework over here. So the website that I'm going to use is VirusTotal. You can also use the next website, which is very popular website, NoDistribute, but I personally like this VirusTotal. So I'll just choose the file and let's go over here, and you can see we have this output and the source. And over here, instead of a source, I want to go to the output and I want this compiled, and the payload name is earpayload.exe file. So let's open that and let's test this file. So first of all, you have to upload that file and wait for some time because it is going to scan all of these antiviruses, and you can see clearly we are just getting some of these antiviruses tracking. Okay, so many of antiviruses are tracking us. So it is not good payload. That means you can see so many of antiviruses. So this is not effective now because 36 out of 70 antiviruses like this Avast, Avira, these are the common antiviruses and they are just tracking us. You can see the Bitdefender is tracking us, so many websites are tracking us. So that means this is not the effective file or the payload that we are doing. So let's make something that is more powerful than this, and let's try to bypass some of these antiviruses. So let's go over here. Our payload is listening, obviously, in this, or basically our handler is listening on this port. So we don't need to do anything over here. Instead, we have to just use this Veil framework in order to make another payload. So let me use again, that is the 15, which is going to be, if you just list all of this payload, the 15 payload is your reverse shell or reverse HTTPS. So I'll just use 15, and you can see clearly now we have this already, the command that is right here. So what I'm gonna do here is let's make some changes. So first of all, I'll just say this method, maybe I'll just go over here. You can just give this user prompt as true or something like that. You can see, and you can also change this sleep. So let's try for this sleep. If I say sleep, maybe 2 seconds or something like this. So I'll just say show options and one more time. So it is only the options, and you can see now we have here two. So let's generate and let's see if this can just bypass our payload. So now I'll just name this new payload and let's hit enter. This is going to encode everything and it will now create that payload, and you can see it is this new payload.exe. Let's open that Firefox again. Let me say I want to go to or navigate this VirusTotal. Let's choose the file over here. So it is new payload, and now let me just upload this first and let's see if now this can just bypass or not. So we haven't changed anything. We have just made something like only change in here. So you can see this doesn't work again. So it is not working at all. So you can see clearly we didn't get anything better than before. So it was same as before. It is also tracking by Avast, and I think it is tracking more than before. It is now 40 out of 67. That must be bad than before or more. And now let's do something else. Let's try to just make some changes now. Let's see, just make changes by let's set these processes. I'll just say let's set these processors B2 now, and let's set this sleep. Let's say set this sleep maybe 1. Let's generate now one more time. Let's hit enter. And now I'll just say this is extended payload. And again, it will just do some of these tasks, the encoding tasks. And now let's go back to our Firefox and let's go back. So okay, it is already uploading. So I'll just open VirusTotal over here. And now let me just choose the file. It is extended payload. And let's upload this file. And let's see if this can bypass some of the antiviruses or not. Okay, it has been tracked one more time. Okay, it is the same as before. So many applications is tracking our payload. That means it is not better than before. It is same as before. So we just tried some of the ways to modify, but it hasn't worked yet. So let's see what the options we can just do over here. So there is not more option over here. You can see we'll just say that minimum processes that they can run, or the RAM check, or the maybe we'll just set the username. That is completely optional, that doesn't do anything maybe. So same as before, you have to try everything over here in order to make that payload undetectable by any antiviruses. Use 15 same as before. Let's set now, let me just go maybe to the processors. I don't want so much processor, I'll just set one. And let's say if I want to set maybe sleep to, let me say 8. Let's see if this works or not. So let's check options one more time. And it is completely fine. I'll just say I want to generate. And I'll just say now this is payload revision, something like this. So let's see if this works or not. So let's go back one more time to the VirusTotal, and I'm just going to navigate over here and let's upload that file as usual. And this time it is payload revision. Let's upload this file first. And maybe this is going to work. It is going to upload, and let's wait for some time. Maybe this file is bigger than before, or let's see if this works or not. So we are waiting. It is again detectable. Okay, we are just waiting. Okay, clearly it is also quite failure, because out of 20 the 14 has detected. And again, this McAfee and the Kaspersky and everything has detected. So you can clearly see this is also not the proper. So we just manage to put it under maybe 40, or it will just touch the 40. So there has been quite improvement, but we want that is no backdoors, or basically no antivirus catch our backdoor. But in this case again, was getting the result that is 39 caught out of 65. That is also the average payload. It is not going to work in all of this machine. That means it is also a complete failure. So you have to just do this couple of time in order to check, or basically in order to see which will work for you. So let's say sleep maybe 6, and let's see, I want to generate, and the payload will be final. So I'm just doing this one last time. Final maybe reverse. So let's hit enter. Now it is again, that is final reverse. Let's go back. Let's check one more time. Hope this will work, because it is just random. I am just assuming something that is completely out of logical. We are just trying random value over there. We don't have any patterns to just denote that this will won't be tracked by antiviruses, because we don't have any access to the antiviruses database or the signatures. So we can just put random value and just try our luck. So it was reverse. It was final reverse. So let's see if this works. So let's press OK. So it is uploading. Let's see how this works. It is also maybe not a good way, because out of 6 or out of maybe 15, 16, 9 has been captured. So it was also a failure. So we didn't get any idea or any pattern till now how to just get bypass to all of these antiviruses. So let's go back, and now instead of going for this here with this HTTPS, but I want to show you a way to create your payload from here. But you can see that we have this bunch of payload. You can now try for this Python meterpreter reverse HTTPS instead of Go. So you can just use this, and you can also try. So let's use that now. So I'll just say that first of all, I want to list, and the Python reverse HTTPS is in 27. So I'll just use that 27, and you can see you have to set again the YL host, and in my case it is the IP address of Kali. Let me set YL port, which will be 8080. And now there is so much of advanced options over here, so I'll just use this set processes maybe, and I'll just say 1, and after that I'll just set sleep a random value maybe 4. After that I'll just say the options again, and it has set what we have just written over here. Let's generate this payload now, and let's say Python reverse. So let's hit enter, and now it is showing that what you want to use. So if you just hit enter, it is going to be PyInstaller, or if you just press 2, it is going to be py2exe. It doesn't really matter, because this both is going to convert your files, Python file, into the exe file. So I'll just stick with this PyInstaller, and it is going to do its work here. You can see the payload is building. Now the payload is the build payload over here, and you can see the executable on the same file, which is the compile file. Let's go over here and let's check if this works or not. Let's try this one more time. So I'm just choosing file as usual, and now it is Python reverse. So let's hope that this work. Let's press OK. Let's wait for some time. It will just do its tasks, and Python is basically what we just see in the next upcoming lecture. We'll learn about the Python, how to make this complete reverse shell with the help of Python. So instead of making use of this Whale framework, we are going to use our backdoor from the Python that we learn in the next lecture. So we'll just make our own payload And in this case, you can see so much of antivirus has detected, but our payload or our backdoor won't be detected by any of the antiviruses. So we'll just make that strong payload or the backdoor that won't be tracked by any of the antiviruses that will be run in any of the operating system, either that can be Linux or the macOS X or Windows, because you know the Python is cross-platform. Only the command that we run on the machine will be Python, or basically they will be specific to operating system. So instead of using those command that is specific to any operating system, we're going to use the command that is particularly based on the Python, because Python works on the Linux and it also work on the Windows and the Mac OS X. That means we'll use the command of only Python that will make our backdoor much more available, or basically it can be used to attack all of these operating system instead of making just based on the particular or specific operating system. We'll make a complete reverse shell that will be cross-platform. That means it will be available, it will be just working on any of the operating system that is available. So this will be wrap for this lecture. So you can clearly see even making this payload with the Python did not work for us. We changed some of these options over here, so it didn't work again. So this will be wrap for this lecture. We'll just try something else in the next lecture, and see you on the next one.